should really preface this by saying we are not, Molly and I are not the target audience for the show, because neither one of us are 13-year-old girls.
No.
But I have to say I really liked it. I thought it was great.
It's funny. It's most definitely... it's not funny. It's funny that we liked it.
That's what I meant, yeah.
It's most definitely the best show on MTV right now. I mean, that's not saying a lot, though. Think about the shows that are on MTV.
Yeah, but because, you know, like, I remember old school MTV. I'm an old man, so I remember stuff like...
When they actually play music videos?
Yeah.
Well, they don't do that anymore. Stuff.
Anyway, so... we are doing, for Teen Wolf, the MTV television show, we are not doing our reviews that we do on Dustin and Molly's movie Reviews for Humans. We're doing our recap. So this is what that is, a recap of the show.
All right, so Teen Wolf, the pilot episode, right?
Mm-hmm.
Introduces Scott McCall as... a young teenage boy plays lacrosse at his local high school.
Badly.
Not very well. He has a best bud.
Styles,
which was awesome because...
Styles. Come on, give it up for Styles.
Oh, Styles. Okay. Well, I think you're talking...
Who's kind of spastic,
well,
but...
Yeah, because, we fell in love with the Styles from the Teen Wolf movie.
Right.
And I think this guy, this actor that plays him... I tried to carry over some of the original Styles. And there was no boof character, though. No.
Makes me sad.
No best girlfriend.
MTV,
unrequited.
Where is the boof? We need a girlfriend who loves him.
Yeah.
But he always just sees her as a friend. And then, you know, we need that.
Styles' father, we find out, is what the sheriff. Is the local sheriff. And Styles comes knocking on Scott's door, wants to go...
Because there's a murder in a foot.
There's a murder in a foot. So they venture into the woods.
To find the body.
To find the body. Kind of Stand By Me-ish.
Because they're young teenagers. And who doesn't remember being 15, 16 years old and going to look for a body in the woods behind your house? If I cannot even count on two hands.
How many times I tried going looking for a body.
Hmm.
So, they're in the woods, something happens.
And they, Styles is discovered by his father.
Yep.
And taken back to the car.
Mm-hmm.
And leaving Scott alone in the woods to be attacked by something.
It bites him on his young, tender handle.
Yes, tender young love handle. And then, so he goes to school the next day, and he's like, I've got a bite! But then he can hear
huge bite.
He's been bitten. Didn't go to his mother and be like, hey, guess what happened to me? Take me to the hospital.
Well, how could they? I mean, he was looking for a dead body in the woods. Hey, Mom, I was looking for a dead body in the woods. Oh, and I got bit. Ah! There's a giant genocide.
Yeah. So he just goes to school, and, like, he tries out for lacrosse, and he makes the team because he's, like, super special, and he's got, like, special hearing. Oh, no, that's the next day. He does it the next day.
It's the next day.
But then they meet Allison, who's the pretty young new girl.
Very,
and she's so
pretty.
And she's so young. And she's so new. But Scott makes an impression on her right away because he uses his super hearing to...
Super hearing.
So then he impresses her by giving her a pen, even though he shouldn't rightly know that she needs a pen because she said it outside and he's in the classroom. Anyway, But he heard it. So they, like, start up a little, like, flirtiness, and Allison becomes friends with the main jock of the school, whose name I remember not at all.
No, but he's got, like, the really angular face,
and
like, classic bully, like, handsome,
and
mean.
The main girl of the school who's redheaded, and I don't remember her name either.
No.
So they all, like, they become friends, and they're like, oh, Scott, we don't know who he is. He's like a guy who does things. And so that's exactly what the redheaded girl says. Allison goes, who's that guy? And she's like, I don't know. I see him sometimes. And it's like, okay, he only goes to your school.
Yeah.
Then Allison hits a dog with her car, takes it to the animal shelter where Scott works.
And he can communicate...
With the dog.
With the dogs telepathically.
Well, I don't know if he can communicate with it, but he definitely, when he looks at it, stops it from barking.
Yeah, he can communicate in some fashion.
And the cats are really angry at him.
The cats do not like him. He's
so,
a wolf.
Yeah. So, what happens, they kind of bond over the dog that she hit, and then...
Styles does research.
He gets it. He's
Styles 3.0, as we call him.
Yeah.
So, Styles does research on werewolves.
And finds and decides that Scott's a werewolf.
And he tells him, dude, you're a werewolf.
Then, yeah, it's gonna happen. And Scott's like, no, I'm not a werewolf. But then he goes to bed one night, and he wakes up the next morning out in the woods. And he has no idea.
In the woods. And that was a really cool transition.
It was a awesome transition.
The quality of the show was, I mean, it's
pretty good.
It surpassed our
expectations. Best show on MTV. So, anyway. So they go to the party that Allison was invited to, and they start like dancing, getting kind of hot and heavy,
and I'm thinking, oh my gosh, he's gonna transform on the dance floor just like in Teen Wolf 2.
But he doesn't. He leaves the party.
He leaves and he transforms.
Yes.
In the woods.
But he thinks that he knows the guy who bit him to make him into a werewolf, and it's a guy named Derek. And Derek is dark and mysterious, and his parents were killed 10 years ago, and he's a little older than them. So Scott freaks out because Derek has Allison, so he goes looking in the woods for them, and he comes across Derek, but Allison, Stiles, goes to Allison's house because, like we've already said, Stiles is actually kind of smart here.
Yeah, so Stiles goes to check on Allison.
And she's at home, like, hanging out. What up?
She's cool. She's good.
And so then Derek and Scott meet up in the woods, and he's like, you're the one who did this to me. And he's like, you love it. It's a gift. And then they're attacked by...
Hunters. Like, werewolf hunters. Yeah.
Yeah.
So,
But they get away.
Yeah.
And
let's go back. Scott was reminding to when Scott first goes into the woods before he encounters Derek, his maker. He's transformed, and I can't figure out if this is the full transformation at this point because he's looking a little Eddie Munster to me.
But there was another point where he's at Scott's in the woods and he sees another werewolf that looks more wolfy. Maybe this is like transitional or...
I don't think in the first episode they want to show us.
Right.
The wolf.
Or maybe Scott's fighting it and this is his like half transformation. It doesn't doesn't matter.
Well, I'm curious. But
I'm sure they'll explain why Scott looks like Eddie Munster.
Okay.
So, they're attacked by hunters in the woods.
The guy says, these and Derek, his maker says, they're werewolf hunters. They've been hunting us for centuries.
Yeah. So they escape, and Stiles comes and actually saves Scott in the woods, like, picks him up. And they drive back, and they go to school the next day, and Scott apologizes to Allison for ditching her at the party. Mm-hmm. And then Allison's like, my dad's here to pick me up. And she runs over to the car, and who is her dad? It is...
The hunter that they encounter in
the
forest.
The main hunter.
So, yeah, he's blue eyes. That was about it.
Yeah. As a first outing, as the first show of the series, I actually liked it. I was really surprised. I was afraid that I wasn't going to like it because we had already committed to do this.
I thought it was going
to
be really, really awful. Not going to lie.
I thought we were going to be having a lot of fun laughing at the show, but I actually really enjoyed it.
We were actually genuinely entertained by it.
This has been... I'm Dustin.
I'm Molly.
And this has been TV Recaps.
For humans.